Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I'll talk about sets. A set is a data type that holds an unordered collection of unique elements. Python uses curly braces to indicate a set, but with elements instead of key value pairs. This is different from dictionaries. Let's see some examples. This D is a dictionary of three key value pairs. Apples, bananas, and oranges are the keys. 33, 47, and 27 are the values. D is a dictionary. This S is a set of four elements of different types. Two strings, one float number, and one integer number. There are no key value pairs. The type function confirms that S is a set. This statement checks whether the number 3 is in S. The answer is false because S does not have an element 3. This statement checks whether the string apples is in S. The answer is true. Note sets only contain unique elements. So when we convert this list of 6 elements to a set, the set only contains 4 unique elements. The length of a set is the number of its elements. In this case, the length of S is 4. Because sets are unordered collections, they don't record element positions. Therefore, sets don't support indexing, slicing, or other sequence-like operations. So for this set S with 4 elements, if you try to access the second element like this, you will see an error. Set object doesn't support indexing. Sets are mutable. That means we can create an empty set and add elements to it later. However, this is not the correct way to create an empty set. In fact, it creates an empty dictionary. To do it correctly, we need to use a set function with no parameters. This time, S is an empty set. The add method will add the element to this set S. We can create a set from a tuple using the set function. Then let's add another element to this set. This element is a string, hello world. Now let's talk about set operations using examples. Set 1 has 3 elements, 1, 2, and 3. Set 2 has 3 elements, 1, 3, and 4. The vertical line is a set union operator. The union operation will combine these two sets, like what I showed here in this image. So the result is 4 unique elements, 1, 2, 3, and 4. The AND sign is the set intersection operator. The intersection operation will return the elements that are in both S1 and S2. In this case, it's 1 and 3. The minus sign is the set difference operator. This difference operator will return the elements that are only in S1 but not in S2. In this case, it's 2. The caret sign is a set symmetric difference operator. This operation will return the elements that are in either S1 or S2, but not in their intersection. In this case, it's 2 and 4. That sign or equal to is the operator we use to check whether S1 is a subset of S2. The answer is false in this case. The greater than sign is the operator we use to check whether S3 is a strict subset of S1. In this case, every element in S3 is also in S1, and there is one element in S1 that is not in S3. This element is number 3, so the answer is true. Let's see a comprehensive example of set operations. A company has 3 engineers, Jane, Jack, Julie, 3 programmers, Jack, Sam, and Susan, and 3 managers, Jin, Susan, and Zach. An employee may belong to 2 groups. For example, Jin is both an engineer and a manager. Jack is both an engineer and a programmer. And Susan is both a programmer and a manager. We can use the union operation to get a complete set of all employees in this company. It is equal to engineers union programmers union managers. The output shows there are 6 unique employees in this company. we can find the people who are both engineers and managers using this intersection operator. We find that only Jin is both an engineer and a manager. We can also find the people who are just a manager, but not an engineer or a programmer using the setDifference operator. Only Zach belongs to this full-time management group. Later, a new engineer named Mark joins the company. We need to add Mark to the engineers group using this add method. Now we have 4 engineers. We also need to add Mark to all employees. So now the company has a total of 7 employees. Later, Susan leaves the company. We need to remove her from every group. We use a for loop to do that. For every group, we remove Susan using the discard method. If Susan is not a member of that group, this discard operation does nothing. The result confirms that Susan is truly removed from all the groups. Okay, that was all about sets. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.